This is a book from my collection on the paintings of Lucian Freud. Paper cover. The hardback is this blue, navy blue linen with silver embossed here. Lucian Freud, born 1922 in Berlin, began showing paintings and drawings in London in the early 1940s and achieved a considerable reputation for his arresting and precise portraits and still lifes. During the 1960s, his work was discounted and its return to public exposure in Britain began with the 1974 retrospective. The Hayward Gallery, and was followed by a growing international interest in the late 1980s. This volume concentrates on the formidable paintings of the last 7 years, the majority previously unseen. Lucian Freud, recent work. Now, this is a self-portrait. Likely, I'm going to have to blur out this area. Whitechapel Art Gallery, London, the Metropolitan Museum of Art, New York, and the Museo Nacional Centro de Art, Reina and Sofia, Madrid. Published by Rizzoli, New York. This is one of Lucian Freud's early works, and the style is very different. It's really a lot like what we think of Alex Katz's paintings. This one too. But I love this painting. Look at how intense that she's looking. Shows a very nice understanding on how to render fabric in hands. This, we're getting into his signature style. It's very painterly. The face. interior with plant, reflection, listening, self-portrait. 1968, oil on canvas. One. Look at how the foreshortening is not quite correct, but I kind of like that about it. Let's see what this one is called. Not sure which one it is. It must be large interior, W11. Painting of his mother. Lord Goodman, 1985, in charcoal. Look at the hash marks. That looks like pen and ink. Head of Bruce Bernard, etching. Also, it's a print. Beautifully done. Here we have the painting that was on the cover. Number 20. Let's see. Double portrait. I guess because it's a dog and the woman. 85 through 86. Oil on canvas. Look how beautifully did her hand. You can see the veins, like mine. Oh, I always loved this one when I was in art school because I felt like you could see his process, which is unlike a lot of people's process in that he really focused here and didn't work the whole canvas all at once. 21. Study for man smoking, oil and canvas. And the next page is man smoking. But obviously they might be from the same sitting. But here he has glasses. There's a pipe in his head. Is that a different position? Of course, in this one he's painted the entire canvas. Thick paint is. There's another etching. This looks like a drawing, which might be a study for this one, which is an etching. This must be his studio sink. Or sink in his place. You can see the chipped tile. And a piece of a painting right here. A lot of models come to his studio, and a lot of these settings that you see, it's just hard to tell what the environment is. I think it's his studio, and these are like piles of sheets and stuff. Bella and Esther, 1988, oil on canvas, 29 by 35 inches. Here we have a close-up. You can really see how he's seems to me like he likes the process just as much as the result when you look at the amount of paint that he uses. Here we have two dogs and a woman. I would hope the paintings wouldn't be scandalous, but it's very clearly a studio. This is beautiful. Thank you. Man in a String Chair, 1889. You can see that this shows up in his studio a lot. This pile of crumpled sheets, or maybe it's canvas. You can recognize the wide planks. That they're showing you these two pictures, because when you just see this painting from a distance, we have probably oil on canvas and then another etching. In this layout, they're giving us the full painting and then a close-up texture of his coat and belt right here. The paint almost looks like it's still wet.